Hello friends, welcome back once again in the video lecture series of Data Communication and Networking. Its subject code is 1618502. Today I am going to teach you unit number 4. Its name is Multi-Channel Data Communication, right? And under this unit, I am going to teach you channel part 2, right? This is my name and designation. So before going deeper into the content, let's state what are the important topics that I will going to cover in this video. So first of all, I will let you know about channel performance measures. Next, I will teach you about channel access method. Next, I will teach you a very important, that is frequency division multiple access. After that, I will try to teach you about time division multiple access. Next, I will teach you about packet mode methods. After that, I will also teach you about duplexing methods. Next, very important, there is hybrid channel access scheme, right? And after that, I will give you a summary which includes all the above topic. Lastly, I will also teach you about, explain you about some references, right? So let's start with the first topic, that is channel performance. So let's start with the first topic, channel performance and measures, right? So there are some examples, commonly examples, which are used in channel capacity and performance measures. They are as follows, right? First one is your spectral bandwidth in hertz. That means bandwidth is measured in terms of hertz. Next one is your symbol rate, which is used in baud or pulse per second, or it is also known as symbols per second. Digital bandwidths are measured in bits per second, right? It is also known as gross bit rate or signaling rate. Also, it is known as a net bit rate, which is also known as information rate. So these are some measures of your digital bandwidth. We are also having channel capacity and maximum throughput, right? Okay. Very important is channel utilization. That means how the channel is being utilized. Link spectral efficiency is also playing a very important role under performance. Next one is your SNR. What do you mean by SNR? That is known as your signal to noise ratio. That means how much noise is being carried with the signal. We should have the measurement in terms of the ratio, and this measure is also known as signal to interference ratio. Noise ratio and interference ratio is almost all same. It is also known as EB/NO, also carrier to interference ratio, which is calculated in the decibels. So these are the performance measures, right? Next one is your bit error rate and packet error rate. Bit error rate are normally calculated in data link layer, and packet error rate is calculated in network layer. Okay. Latency in seconds. What is latency? Latency means to what amount of time is needed to search a particular bit is known as your latency. Propagation time and transmission time is also playing an important role in performance measures. Delay jitter. Delay jitter is the delay in receiving the packet from the sender end to receiver end, which may deteriorate the quality of your product, right? Next, talk about channel access method. So in telecommunication and computer networks, channel access method is also known as multiple access method, that is your MAC, right? Basically, it allows more than two terminals to connect on the same transmission medium. That means the medium will, transmission medium will be same, but this medium can be connected with more than two terminals, means two or more than two terminals. In order to transmit the high data, right? Okay. So, what are the examples of shared physical media? Shared physical media may be your wireless network, bus network, ring network, and point-to-point links. So, all these are your different network topology, which includes half duplex method. Right? Okay. The channel access method, that is your CAM, is based on multiplexing. It is purely based on multiplexing, right? Which allows several data streams or signals to share the same communication channel or transmission medium. See, this channel access method is used for in that situation when several data streams wants to access the same communication channel and transmission channel. So, in that situation, channel access method plays an important role, right? So, in this situation, multiplexing is very, very important, which is occurred at physical layer. So, it is done by your MAC, and it is also the full form of MAC is your medium access control. Although, I will discuss MAC in detail in data link layer. So, MAC deals with the issue such as addressing, IP addressing, assigning the multiplex channel to the different users and avoiding the collision. So, MAC is responsible for all these challenges which may happen in data link layer. Okay. So, MAC is a sublayer which is using data link layer, as if I have already told you, and it is being first of all introduced in OSI model, and later on it was implemented in TCP/IP model. So let's talk about first frequency division, multiple access, right? It is also known as FDMA. What do you mean by FDMA? That is your frequency division multiple access. It is a scheme in which the most standard analog signals, that means it is used basically for analog signal, and this FDMA was totally depending upon your FDM scheme, right? It provides the frequency band of the different data stream. So, different data stream may have different bands. What are different bands? That is different frequency, right? Okay, fine. So, in the case of FDMA, the frequency band are allocated to different nodes or devices. So, alag alag jo frequency bands hain, wo alag alag devices mein allocated hote hain. Kis case mein? FDMA, right? Okay. The example of FDMA system is first generation, and first generation is also known as 1G, which was used in your cell phone systems. Okay. Each phone calls which is assigned a specific uplink frequency channel, right, and other downlink frequency channel. So, where it was basically used, it was used in the phone calls where we are using uplink frequency channel and downlink frequency channel. Each message signal is also known as your information signal or baseband signal, is modulated with specific carrier frequency, right? Okay. So, in FDMA also the modulation process is going on. A related technique which is also known as WDMA. What is WDMA? That is your wavelength division multiple access. Although I will going to teach you this segment in quite detail in separate lecture, right? Okay. So, different data stream may have different color in fiber optics communication. So, if you are talking about fiber communication or fiber optical communication, So these data streams are basically represented by, if we talk about some more important point regarding frequency division multiple axis. So basically in this WDMA is also there. So in this, basically network nodes or different hubs are being represented with the different color. So once for all we are talking about FDMA. So FDMA, the advanced version of FDMA is also known as OFDMA, right? Okay. So basically this is used in 4G cellular communication system. And basically what OFDMA works, basically in this OFDMA, each node is having several carriers, and basically these different subcarriers is making possible to provide different quality services to different users. So whenever you are having different users with having different services, at that time we have to have need several sub carriers, right? And it is possible in your OFDMA only, right? So basically the assignment of these sub carriers is to change it dynamically, which is based on your two things. First is your radio channel condition, current radio channel condition, and second one is your traffic load, right? And some more FDMA varieties or types are also known as SCFDMA. What is SCFDMA? It is a single carrier FDMA or SCFDMA, right? And it is also known as your linearly pre-coded, that is your LPOFDMA. So these are the different varieties of your OFDMA, and it is based on single carrier frequency domain equalization, which is also known as SCFDE. Okay, so we can talk about FDMA in this diagram. This is your frequency band, which is allocated by FCC. We are having so many channels, that is channel 1, 2, 3, 4 up to channel N, and at each channel we are having some electronic gadgets such as mobile. Here we are manipulating the graph as per frequency, and upper side we are talking about your FDMA, right? So next talk about time division multiple axis. So time division multiple axis is also known as TDMA, which is totally based on time division multiplexing TDM scheme, right? So isme hota kya hai? So TDMA provides different time slots to different transmission, which acts in cyclic and repetitive frames. So basically once we are talking about TDMA, so whenever we have to go for different transmitter, at that time different time slots will be given to them, and it will be in the cyclic or repetitive frame structure. How? That is, node 1 may be given time slot 1, node 2 may be given time slot 2, node 3 will be given time slot 3, and so on, right? Okay, so what is the advanced version of TDMA? It is known as dynamic TDMA, that is known as DTMA, dynamic time division multiple axis, right? Where an assignment of transmitter to time slot varies with each frame. So as the frame varies, the time slot will be also vary, right? Okay, so next one is your multi-frequency time division multiple axis, which is also known as MFTDMA, which combines the time and frequency multiple axis, right? So this is also a one good variety of your TDMA. So basically once we are talking about 2G cellular system, so 2G cellular system is the combination of your TDMA, that is time division multiplexing, and frequency division multiple axis. So some more important point about time division multiple axis is, each channel is divided into 8 slots, out of which 7 is given to mobiles and 1 is given to your signaling data. Statistical time division multiplexing access is typically used, which is based on time division, time domain multiplexing, right? So whenever we are talking about statistical time division multiplexing, it is depending on time domain multiplexing, right? And it is not circular or repetitive frame structure, right? Due to its random character, basically it can be categorized as statistical multiplexing method and capable of dynamic bandwidth allocation. What do you mean by dynamic bandwidth allocation? That means we can change the difference between two frequency, right? Okay, so for this MAC protocol is very we are using MAC protocol in data link layer, right, for TDMA. And some common example of such type of multiple access is CSMA, which is used in your bus network, hub networks, and CSMA or CA. What are all these? We will discuss in the latter session, right? And basically, we are introducing these type of protocols as IEEE 802.11. This is the nomenclature given to the different protocols, right? Okay. So this is the formal difference between FDMA, TDMA, and CDMA, right? So in FDMA, the slots are going in this way, right? In the frequency axis, right? And in this TDMA, the slots are going in the direction 90 degree to the frequency in this way, in the term of time. Here we are having three types of access. One is your frequency, second one is your code, and third one is your time, right? Okay. And in CDMA, it will goes, the slots will goes like this way, right? In the code direction. Okay, fine. So next, talk about packet mode method. And in packet mode method, first of all, what is packet mode method? So it is a channel access method. Select a single network transmitter for duration of a packet transmission. So whenever we have to transmit the packet, at that time it will select a particular single transmitter, right, which is attached with the network, and that is known as your packet mode method. Some methods may be wired communication and some of them are wireless. That means packet mode method is applicable for both wireless and wired communication. So common statistical time division multiplexing, that is multiple access protocol for wired multiple multi-drop network, includes the following protocols. First is your CSMA CD. What is CSMA CD? Carrier sends multiple access with the collision detection, right? Next one is your MACA, that is your multiple access with collision avoidance. Here we are detecting, here we are avoiding, right? Collision should be avoided. Multiple access with the collision avoidance for wireless, it is known as MACAW, right? Okay. Next one is your, when you are talking about CSMA, so in CSMA, it is known as your carrier sends multiple access, and in this we are using CSMA CARP. What is that? This is your carrier sends multiple access with collision, right? Collision avoidance and resolution using priority. Collision, C for collision, A for avoidance, R for resolution using P for priority. So we are also using CAN bus, that is based on your bit arbitration, and for this we are using certain protocols, that is your code for token bus. We are using IEEE 802.4. For token ring, we are using IEEE 802.5. For token passing, we are using FIDI, that is FDDI. Okay. And we are also using dynamic TDMA. So here we are having a very good example of your packet mode method, in which we are talking about CSMA, CSMA oblique CA, that is your career avoidance, right, which is used in IEEE 802.11, right. Next one is your, we are also using Aloha and Slotted Aloha, which is used in your AlohaNet. We are also using Reservation Aloha, that is R Aloha, along with Mobile Slotted Aloha, that is your MS Aloha, right. We are also using Code Division Multiple Access, that is known as your CDMA. And as if I have already discussed about orthogonal frequency time, orthogonal frequency division multiple access, that is OFDMA. And orthogonal frequency division multiplexing is known as OFDM. So here it is the figure where several signals are coming here. They are being composed and they are being multiplexed to transmit through a one channel, and at receiver end it will be demultiplexed, and the same original message, same original signal will be received to the receiver end. Okay. So next, talk about demultiplexing method. And in demultiplexing method, although it is not very very useful for you, so I have given a quite brief discussion on this. The method are used for dividing the forward and reverse communication channel. They are known as duplexing method, and basically this is used in the half duplex or full duplex. This duplexing method is basically used in half duplex and full duplex, right. So in half duplex, communication is only works in at one direction, we all know. And in full duplication, in half duplex system, we are using walkie-talkie, right? Okay, fine. And some of the full duplex methods are your TDD, that is your time division duplex, and FDD, that is your frequency division duplex. So, and also we are using echo cancellation. So these are the walkie-talkie which is using in your half duplex method. So this is the sender and this is the receiver. Once the sending process is going on, at that time receiver cannot send, and when receiver is sending the message, the sender has to receive it. Okay. So last but not least, let us discuss about hybrid channel access scheme also. That is also very important. So we are having certain example of this, that is your GSM cellular system, which combines the use of FDD to prevent interference between outward and return signal. So basically GSM SIM is used for detecting the noise with the help of your FDMA and TDMA. Okay. So GSM with GPRS packet switch service combines FDD and FDMA with slotted Aloha. All these things we are discussing, we are going to discuss in computer networks when I will teach you computer network, right. So this is a good example of your FDMA. See how it works. This is your time, this is your frequency, this is your power. And the TDMA is quite reverse of your FDMA in this way it is using. And once if you are talking about the pure Aloha, so we are having certain channels, that is A, B, C, D, E, and this packet is transmitting from here to here in this way, that is from left to right. So let's talk about summary in brief that we have covered so far. First one is your, a channel access method is based on multiplexing, that is very very important, and which allows the several data stream or signal to share the same communication channel or transmission medium, right. Okay. Next one is your, in context with multiplexing which is provided, and this will be provided at the physical layer only. The channel access method may also be the part of your multiple access protocol and control mechanism, which is also known as your MAC. Mac deals with the issue such as addressing, assigning multiplex channel to different users and avoiding collision. So whenever you want to go for collision avoidance, so at that time Mac protocol plays an important role. So next one, in the case of FDMA, frequency bands are allocated to different nodes or different devices, right? The example of FDMA is BIS, that is first generation, this is 1G cell phone system. Each phone calls are assigned to a specific uplink and downlink channel, which is having different frequency. And as per Shannon-Hartley theorem, the wide bandwidth net, it is possible to send with a signal to noise ratio. Signal to noise ratio is very important while sending the message through the transmission, because it shows how much, what is the ratio of noise that is being transmitted through the signal. So these are good references for your books, URL in YouTube. Thank you so much for watching this video. Have a nice day.